Today we will learn regarding mandible bone. Mandible is the largest and strongest bone of the face. It is made by two parts, body and two rami. Body and two rami on each side. Body, it is U-shaped, convex forwards. It has two surfaces, anterior surface and posterior surface, upper border and lower border, external surface. Now regarding surfaces, external surface convex forward, U shape. There is a fine ridge in the median part of the mandible, which indicates the fusion of the two halves of the mandible. It is termed as symphysis menti. Below the symphysis menti, there is a small triangular raised area termed as mental protuberance. Its apex directed upward, base directed downward, and forms the prominent part of the chin. At its lateral angle of the mental protuberance has a small tubercle on each side, termed as mental tubercle. Now, external oblique line starts from the mental tubercle, runs backward, upward, and continues with the anterior border of ramus. Its anterior part in front gives origin to depressor labii inferioris. Posterior part gives origin to depressor anguli oris. Posterior part of the margin gives attachment to buccinator. Below the external oblique line receives insertion of latissima muscle. Now regarding mental foramen lies between first and second premolar. It is directed backward and upward, continuous with the mandibular foramen and mandibular canal, give passage for mental nerve and vessels. Now this is first incisor, this is second incisor. Below the incisor teeth there is a small depression area termed as incisive fossa, gives origin to mentalis muscle and few slips of orbicularis oris. Here incisive fossa and gives attachment to mentalis muscle and few slips of orbicularis oris muscle. Now regarding posterior surface is concave. It has a mylohyoid ridge which continues from the below the third molar tooth and continuous runs downward, forward, and meets the symphysis menti. It divides the area into small triangular area and submandibular fossa, and above part is termed as sublingual fossa and lower part is termed as submandibular fossa. Sublingual fossa is concave, triangular and rounded part, lodges the submandibular salivary gland, sublingual gland, and below the sublingual gland, submandibular fossa lodges the submandibular salivary gland, submandibular lymph node and facial artery on each side. Okay, this was regarding mylohyoid ridge. This is mylohyoid reach. Okay. Now, lingual groove. A lingual nerve passes above the mylohyoid line and below the third molar and forms the lingual groove. Now, below the mylohyoid line and it forms the mylohyoid groove below the third molar and mylohyoid line, mylohyoid groove, which continuous runs downward, forward and merge with the submandibular fossa. Mylohyoid here, attachment of mylohyoid line or ridge, it gives attachment to mylohyoid muscle, mylohyoid muscles in its posterior end, gives attachment to superior constrictor muscle of pharynx and pterygomandibular raphe. Pterygo, superior constrictor muscle of pharynx and pterygomandibular raphe. And here mylohyoid groove give passage for mylohyoid nerve and vessels. Okay, clear. Now regarding border, upper border and lower border. Upper border is termed as alveolar border. It has 8 socket on each sides which lodges the teeth. Teeth is covered by alveolar bone which gives attachment to periodontal membrane. An alveolar bone of teeth is covered by mucoperiosteum membrane. Now, lower border. Lower border is thick, rounded. It has a small depression on each side, termed as digastric fossa. It gives origin to anterior belly of digastric muscle. Digastric muscle has two belly, anterior belly and posterior belly. Now regarding ramus. Ramus, this is part. Ramus is flat, quadrilateral portion projected upward and backward from the posterior end of the body. It has four border and two surfaces. Four border, anterior border, posterior border, superior border and inferior border. Lateral surface and medial surface. Lateral surface rough throughout except posterior superior part, which is covered by parotid gland. Rough area gives attachment to masseter muscle. Now, medial surface smooth and it has irregular foramen, which is termed as mandibular foramen. Continuous or opens in it opens into the mental foramen. It give passage for inferior alveolar nerve and vessels. Now, below the mandibular foramen, mylohyoid groove runs downward, forward and merges with the submandibular fossa. Give passage for mylohyoid vessels and nerves. Below and behind the mylohyoid groove, smooth area gives attachment to medial pterygoid muscle. Now here medial margin of the mandibular foramen has a sharp process termed as lingula. At its inferior part gives attachment to sphenomandibular ligament. Now regarding border, anterior border is sharp, prominent and forms the anterior border of the coronoid process and receives insertion of temporalis muscle. Posterior border thick, rounded and concave in the middle part, continuous with the mandibular angle and below the lower border of the ramus. Now mandibular angle. Posterior border and inferior border of the ramus forms the angle of mandible which gives attachment to stylomandibular ligament. Here we will discuss importance of the angle of mandible. Angle of mandible is everted in males and inverted in females. Okay. Now superior border. Superior border represents coronoid process, condyloid process, and mandibular notch. Coronoid process, its anterior border continues below with the external oblique line, and posterior margin forms the anterior boundary of the mandibular notch. It receives insertion of temporalis muscle. Here its tip is broken. Its apex directed upward, base fused with the anterior border of ramus. Now mandibular notch wide, concave. It's anteriorly bounded by posterior boundary of coronoid process, and posteriorly it is continuous with the head of mandible. It give passage for the masseter vessels and nerve. Now regarding inferior border starts in front of the base of the mandible and ends at the angle of mandible. Now head of mandible, condyloid process projects upward and backward from the mandibular notch. Head is expanded transversely, or its diameter more transversely than the anteroposterior diameter. It articulates with the mandibular fossa of temporal bone. Its margin gives attachment to synovial membrane of temporomandibular joint. Now its neck is constricted part below the head. Its lateral and posterior boundary, posterior part is related with lateral ligament of temporomandibular joint. Again we have forgot here, below the head there is rounded tubercle which gives attachment to lateral ligament of TMJ. Neck is constricted part below the head. Its lateral and posterior margin or part gives attachment to lateral ligament of TMJ. And anterior border of the neck has a small depression, termed as pterygoid fovea, gives attachment to medial pterygoid muscles. So we have covered most of parts. Thank you for watching this video. Okay.